So in the last lecture, we understood the definition of optical isomerism. Two compounds are said to be optical isomers if their optical activity is different. What is meant by optical activity? The rotation of the plane of polarized light is called as optical activity. If one of the compound is rotating the light in the clockwise sense, the other compound, its mirror image will be rotating in the anti-clockwise sense. If you have optical isomers, the only physical property that is going to be different is optical activity. There won't be any difference in the boiling point, in the melting point, in the refractive index, in the density. All these properties won't be different. There is only one property that is going to be different, which is optical activity. Okay? The necessary and sufficient condition in order to have optical isomers is asymmetry. The molecule should be unsymmetrical. Such a molecule is called as chiral. A chiral matlab, the molecule is symmetrical. Chiral matlab, the molecule is unsymmetrical. Any object which is unsymmetrical will be having a mirror image, and both the mirror image cannot be superimposed on each other. Today we will understand in detail what is meant by superposition, how exactly they are not superimposable on each other. Okay. Last lecture mein humne two dimensional mein kuch dekha hai to see if a given object is superimposed on its mirror image or not. Agreed? Okay. So chirality is the necessary and sufficient condition for a molecule to have optical isomers. You will be having, if there is an optical isomerism, you will be having two optical isomers. That compound along with its mirror image. Okay? ठीक है. उसके बाद हमने वो optical activity होता क्या है उसके बारे में पढ़ा. Then we have understood what is meant by dextrorotatory and levorotatory. The angle by which the plane of polarized light can be rotated, that particular angle is called as observed rotation. That observed rotation depends upon the concentration of the sample. More are the number of samples the light is going to encounter, more will be the rotation. Agreed? Okay. So it depends upon two factors. One is the concentration and the other is the length of the polarimeter. Greater is the length of the polarimeter, more will be the number of molecules that are going to be encountered. Agreed? Accordingly, there will be more and more deviation. So, if you want a specific rotation for any given compound, because observed rotation, jo hai, even though the compound is the same, you can have different observed rotations based on the different concentration and different length of the polarimeter. In order to have a unique value, कोई भी कंपाउंड के लिए एक पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू तो सेम रहेगा. व्हाट इज दैट स्पेसिफिक रोटेशन? स्पेसिफिक रोटेशन मतलब यू नीड टू डिवाइड दैट पर यूनिट लेंथ एंड पर यूनिट कंसंट्रेशन. ओके, सो उसी के बारे में यहां पे लिखा. द स्पेसिफिक रोटेशन इज नथिंग बट अल्फा ऑब्जर्वड पर यूनिट कंसंट्रेशन एंड पर यूनिट लेंथ. दिस विल बी कांस्टेंट फॉर एनी गिवन कंपाउंड व्हिच इज काइरल. ओके, उस कंपाउंड के लिए कांस्टेंट है, दूसरे कंपाउंड के लिए वैल्यू अलग रहेगा. नो मैटर व्हाट द कंसंट्रेशन एंड नो मैटर व्हाट द लेंथ ऑफ द पोलारिमीटर यू टेक. Is that clear? Okay. Dextro or levo samajh mein aaya na? Uske baad we kept a heading chiral carbon and chiral compound. Chiral carbon. Chiral ka matlab unsymmetric or asymmetric. Chiral carbon matlab asymmetric carbon. Chiral compound matlab asymmetric compound. In order to have a chiral carbon, you need to have all the four groups attached to the carbon, sp3 hybridized carbon, different. इस लेक्चर में वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड क्यों सारे के सारे डिफरेंट होना चाहिए. इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी टू ग्रुप सिमिलर विल दैट बी काइरल और नॉट, वी विल एनालाइज दैट, डोंट वरी. ओके, अभी के लिए डेफिनेशन क्या है काइरल कार्बन? एन sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन हैविंग फोर डिफरेंट ग्रुप्स अटैच्ड टू इट विल बी डेफिनेटली काइरल. ओके, काइरल कॉम्पाउंड का मतलब क्या है? And this particular center, this chiral carbon is also called as chiral center or stereogenic center or stereo center or asymmetric center. Any doubt, anyone? Okay. उसके बाद chiral compound. Chiral compound मतलब क्या होगा? Asymmetric compound. In order to understand if a given compound will be asymmetric or not, see if there is a chiral carbon or not. If you are having one chiral carbon, केवल एक ही है. Then I can definitely say the compound will be chiral compound. Iska matlab ye nahi hai, only if you see chiral carbon, the compound will be chiral. Need not be. This is one of the rule to identify if a given compound is chiral or not. What is the rule? To check for the chiral carbon. If you are having one chiral carbon, ek hi chiral carbon raha to, the compound will definitely be chiral. We will understand what will happen if you have more than one chiral carbon. We will see that. But if you have one chiral carbon, definitely chiral hoga. Okay? But this is not the only condition in order to have a given compound as chiral. There can be some other conditions too. Overall condition kya hai? The molecule has to be asymmetric. To judge if a given molecule is asymmetric or not, one of the rule is to see if there is one chiral carbon. Is that clear? In this lecture, we will be seeing all these conditions. Okay, don't worry. All organic molecules containing one asymmetric carbon, that is chiral carbon, are always optically active. Always optically active matlab, they will be having a mirror image. Both of them will be rotating the plane of polarized light. If one rotates in clockwise, that the other will be rotating in anti-clockwise direction. Clear? Everyone, any doubt? Any doubt, anyone at this point, please ask me. Okay.
Nice, sir.
Okay. Please put your video on. Everyone, very few students have kept their video on. Okay, today's attendance is 65. Good to see. Very, very important. All this. Abhi sab log aaye the na, isliye bata raha hu fir se. These particular concepts of organic chemistry, very important. Organic chemistry is very easy to score. If you listen to all the lectures, if you are unfortunate, you will be having your boards exams. So, us boards exams mein organic hi major part rahega. If you are thorough with your organic, you can score 60%, minimum 60%. Okay, remaining 40% will be of physical and inorganic. Inorganic may be limited set hai 12th mein. Kya kya aata hai, sab kuch well defined hai. Us section se hi aayega, is section se hi aayega. So, we will be reading those sections. Easy hai, you need to remember, but for organic, you need to remember everything. Okay? Okay. Next side heading. Mirror experiment. And superimposability. Okay, so aap log. How are you guys? Can you hear me? Okay. Case one. Case one, on an sp3 hybridized carbon, if you have three groups same, what is meant by chiral carbon? If you have all the four groups different, na, only that particular carbon will be chiral or it will be asymmetric. So let us see what will happen if you are having three groups as same and one is different. And one is different. Okay. I'm having a carbon. For any sp3 hybridized atom, you will be having two bonds in the plane. One bond will be coming out of the plane and another bond will be going into the plane. Agreed? I'm having three groups similar. and two groups different. Sorry, and one group different. So यहाँ पे I'm taking hydrogen, यहाँ पे भी hydrogen ले रहा हूँ, यहाँ पे भी hydrogen ले रहा हूँ. I'm taking another group as CH3. Okay? If I place a mirror here, I'm placing a mirror here. So उसका mirror image कैसे दिखेगा? Everyone? CH3 जो है, it will remain here. The hydrogen which is present on this side, it will be going this side. यहाँ पे मिरर रखा तो ये जो पर्टिकुलर हाइड्रोजन इस साइड है, it should be going this side. So यहाँ पे एक हाइड्रोजन रहेगा. Okay. These two bonds, one bond is coming out of the plane, and the other bond is going into the plane. So mirror यहाँ पे अगर आप लोग इस पॉइंट पे मिरर रख रहे तो on this side also this hydrogen will be coming out of the plane and this hydrogen will be into the plane. Agreed? Will there be any difference? I'm placing mirror here. एक अंदर है, एक बाहर है. मिरर रखा तो ये जो बॉन्ड है which is going inside, अभी भी it will be present inside the plane. This will be out of the plane. Agreed? Any doubt? यहाँ पे एक हाइड्रोजन, दिस इज गोइंग टू बी CH3. हाइड्रोजन हाइड्रोजन हाइड्रोजन. Are these two superimposable or non-superimposable? What do you think? Are these two superimposable or non-superimposable?
Non-superimposable.
Non-superimposable? Ek minute rukna.
Superimposable.
Am I audible? Am I audible, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Everyone observe here. This particular molecule, this is having three groups similar. This is an sp3 hybridized carbon. Everyone observe this. It is an sp3 hybridized carbon. It is having three groups similar and one group different. Agreed? Okay. Observe this. These two are in the plane. One of the bond is coming out of the plane and the other bond is going into the plane. Agreed? One bond is coming out of the plane and the other bond is going into the plane. The mirror image of it looks like this. Okay. If I try to superimpose this, they are getting superimposed. Right? The red part is superimposing with this. The three reds are superimposing with each other and the green is also superimposing it with it. Agreed? So these two are mirror images of each other and they are superimposable mirror images. They are not non-superimposable. Clear hai? So will this molecule be a chiral molecule or a chiral molecule? Okay. A chiral?
Okay.
I hope this is clear. Okay. Everyone understand this. You are having three groups similar and three groups similar. This is the mirror image. This is the mirror image and both the mirror images are superimposable. Okay. Is this fine? Okay. Let us go to the next condition. Abhi kya kiya humne? We have taken three groups similar and one group different.
आप लोग इसको ऐसा भी सोच सकते हो, एवरीवन अंडरस्टैंड दिस, यहाँ पे आप लोग को नॉन सुपरइम्पोजिबल लगाना, रोटेट दिस बाय 180 डिग्रीज अबाउट दिस एक्सिस. इफ यू आर रोटेटिंग दिस बाय 180 डिग्रीज, व्हाट विल हैपन? दिस पर्टिकुलर हाइड्रोजन विच इज प्रेजेंट ऑन दिस साइड, इट विल बी गोइंग टू दिस साइड. ओके, सो दिस विल बी सुपर इम्पोजिंग विद दिस. ये तो यही पे है, सो दिस विल सुपर इम्पोज. दिस टू बॉन्ड्स ऑल्सो विल सुपर इम्पोज विद दिस टू. If you want to understand this in the plane of paper, rotate this by 180 degrees. The bond which is present on this side, now it will be going to this side. This is the three-dimensional object. Okay? Sorry. Let me know if you have any doubt. Please raise your hand. If you have any doubt, please raise your hand.
बोला आवेश, आई थिंक यू हैव सम डाउट.
सर जब 180 डिग्री रोटेट करेंगे तो जो हाइड्रोजन पहले इनटू द प्लेन था वो बाद में आउट ऑफ द प्लेन आ जाएगा ना?
वो हो जाएगा, वेरी गुड. बट बोथ ऑफ देम आर हाइड्रोजन्स ओनली ना. ये हाइड्रोजन इसके साथ सुपरइम्पोज हो या ये वाला इसके साथ हो, क्या फर्क पड़ेगा? बोथ ऑफ देम आर हाइड्रोजन्स ओनली, राइट? ओके, सही है. इसने जो भी कहा, the hydro, if I am rotating it by 180 degrees, the hydrogen which is present out of the plane, now it will go into the plane, but it will, that is also hydrogen only, this will superimpose with this, no issues. Okay, so if you are having a carbon which is having three groups same and one group different, will that be ever chiral?
No.
Yes, sir.
Okay, case two. केस टू में क्या रखना चाहिए हमें? व्हेन अभी थ्री ग्रुप सिमिलर लिया ना, टू ग्रुप सेम लेते हैं. टू ग्रुप्स आर सेम एंड two are different. Okay, carbon two bonds will be in plane, one of the bond is going into the plane and one bond is coming out of the plane. Again I am taking two hydrogens. Okay, I'm taking two chlorines. Yahan pe chlorine, yahan pe chlorine. How will it mirror image look? Yahan pe bond aa jayega, ye aisa hi rahega. हाइड्रोजन एनी डाउट एनीवन? सो यहाँ पे एक हाइड्रोजन, यहाँ पे एक हाइड्रोजन, यहाँ पे एक क्लोरीन, यहाँ पे एक क्लोरीन. एग्रीड? ओके, बिफोर सीइंग द मॉडल एक बार आप लोग ही सोचो, यहाँ पे आर दिस टू सुपर इम्पॉसिबल मिरर इमेजेस आर नॉट? Are they superimposable or not?
Superimposable.
Then you can do the same thing, which is rotate this by angle of 180 degrees. What will happen? The bond which is present here, wo is side aa jayega. Okay, so this bond will be superimposing with this. Ye dono hydrogens hi hai. So both of them can be superimposed. Let us take the model. Yeah, if you see this particular model, yeah,
you are having okay the thing is two groups are same and two are different na mai upar bhi wahan pe cl liya everyone that will also give you the same answer make this as ch3 this is ch3 two groups are similar which are hydrogen and hydrogen and two are different I need to take two different groups make this as ch3 even now if you are rotating this by 180 degrees you will be having cl here in this direction ch3 to yahi pe rahega both the ch3s will be superposed and both the hydrogens will be superposed agreed this is the example for that yeah ek minute huh? Everyone observe this. This is one compound. You are having two groups similar, two groups different. Okay. This is the another compound which is the mirror image of it. Agreed. देखो white के सामने white, पीछे red है. Okay. I hope this is visible. This is the mirror image. If I am trying to superpose this. This is not superimposed if I am trying to superimpose in this way but you can always rotate it you can rotate it by 180 degrees see here now this got superimposed the white is got superimposed with white red red ke sath and two yellows with both agreed Can you observe this? Is this clear? Red red के साथ, white white के साथ and yellows yellows के साथ. Okay, these two are not the same. These two are the same compounds because they are getting superimposed. If they are non-superimposable, no matter what. Initially, this is the mirror image. Okay, initially this is the mirror image. You may think these as two different compounds. They won't be different compounds if their mirror images are superimposable on each other. If you are trying to superimpose as it is, you may think they are not getting superimposed. But you can rotate this image. The entire thing is the image, na? You can rotate this. I am rotating this. Okay, and I am trying to superimpose it. Then it is getting superimposed. देखो. White white के साथ, red red के साथ, yellows yellows के साथ. Agreed? Clear है? Okay. Let us go to the fourth condition. Third condition. So I can call these molecules as achiral. This is achiral. This also. Achiral. Let us go to the next case. Case 3 क्या होगा? Starting में हमने तीन groups same रखा, एक different रखा. बाद में दो groups को same रखा, दो को different रखा. अब क्या रखेंगे?
Different ones.
What should be the condition now?
Four different. Three different and one same.
One same का क्या मतलब हुआ? Four different.
Four different.
Okay. When all four are different. When all four are different. There will be two groups in the plane. Let us take the groups as एक CS3 ले रहा हूँ, एक CL ले रहा हूँ, one is hydrogen and the other is CH2CH3. Okay, all the four are different. Its mirror image is going to be यहाँ पे कार्बन, ये बॉन्ड एज इट इज वैसा ही रहेगा. The bond which is present on left, it will go to the right hand direction. ये अभी भी into the plane ही होगा and this will be out of the plane. यहाँ पे आपको क्लोरीन आएगा, हियर यू विल गेट CH3, देयर इज हाइड्रोजन हियर, देयर इज CH2CH3 हियर. एग्रीड? ओके, नाउ ट्राई टू रोटेट दिस. इफ यू ट्राई टू रोटेट दिस बाय 180 डिग्रीज, व्हाट विल हैपन? Cl जो है इस साइड तो आ जाएगा, but the hydrogen which is present out of the plane, now this will be going into the plane. So ye CH2CH3 ke sath hydrogen will be overlapping, and CH2CH3 which is going into the plane, now with this will come out of the plane if you rotate by 180 degrees. Okay, so this will be overlapping with this. So no matter what, you can never overlap these things with each other. Okay, ek bar uske liye bhi ek model dekh lete hain. Okay. Observe these two mirror images. Agreed?
These two are mirror images of each other. If you try to superimpose them, okay, no matter what, you can never superimpose two balls. ये जो white है, white के साथ superimpose हो रहा है, red red के साथ superimpose हो रहा है, but यहाँ पे देखो, black is superimposing with blue, and this blue is superimposing with black. If you try to rotate this. Here you are trying to superimpose black with black, blue with blue, agreed? But here white is superimposing with red and red is superimposing with white. Clear? Okay. Once the center reopens, I will give you these models. If you try to superimpose them, no matter what, you can never superimpose two groups. Only two groups can be superimposed, other two groups won't be superimposing. Okay. So these two are, even though they look exactly same, na, yahan pe dekhna, you are having four groups, everyone, you are having four groups, which are, ek minute, you are having four groups, ek blue hai, ek red hai, ek black hai, ek white hai. Yahan pe bhi wahi four groups hai, red, black, white and blue. So you may feel both the compounds are exactly same. Understand that. If I don't give you the definition of that, if at the start of the lecture, if I give you these two compounds, you will definitely feel these two are the same compounds, right? Agreed? Because all the four groups attached to it are same. This can be same here. If you observe the distances between the groups, ये red और blue के बीच में जो distance है, यहाँ पे भी वही distance है. ब्लैक और व्हाइट में जो डिस्टेंस है, यहाँ पे भी वही डिस्टेंस है. इनफैक्ट द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन एनी टू ग्रुप्स हियर विल बी एग्जैक्टली सेम व्हेन कंपेयर्ड टू द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन those two groups in this molecule? Agreed? If the distances are same, can I say the interaction among the molecules will be same? If the interactions among the molecules are same, the boiling point of this molecule, the boiling point of this molecule, the melting point of this molecule, the melting point of this molecule will be same. Their packing will be same. Everything is going to be same. They are not geometrical isomers. Understand this. If they are geometrical isomers, the geometrical distances must be different. They are a special type of stereoisomers. Everyone, they are special type of stereoisomers where you are having different properties. That different property is only the optical activity. Okay? Rest all other properties will be same because the distances are same, the interactions are going to be same in both the molecules. Agreed? Okay. Once again, tell me the definition of, everyone, tell me the definition of stereoisomerism. How to get stereoisomers? We can get stereoisomers by interchanging two groups which are present on the same compound. Everyone, observe this. A black or A red, dono exact same positions mein hai. Here you are having black, here you are having blue. If I interchange this blue with white, what will happen? You will be getting this molecule.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these particular molecules also satisfy the definition by interchanging two groups which are present on the same carbon. Is carbon ke upar do groups hai, blue and white. I'm interchanging them. So white will come here and blue will go here, which will be this molecule. In the process, you are generating a new molecule. Why am I saying a new molecule? Because this will be having rotation in clockwise sense. Then this will be having the rotation in anti-clockwise sense. Okay. I'm saying that this is rotating in clockwise. So then this will definitely rotate in anti-clockwise. It's mirror image. Agreed? Is the definition of optical isomers, why the boiling point, melting point, all of these will be same? Samajh mein aaya? Okay. I hope this is clear to everyone. If you have any doubt, ask me now.
Any doubt, anyone? Okay. The thing you need to remember is, if you have four groups different on a carbon, that particular carbon will definitely be chiral. Bas, that is the take-home message. Baki sab aapke understanding ke liye bataya. By taking two groups same, two groups different, three groups same, one group different. Okay. If you have one chiral carbon, then the compound will be definitely be chiral. Let us see a case where you will be not seeing any chiral carbon, yet the compound will be chiral. For this, you need to know how to draw the structure of the molecule, which we have seen in chemical bonding. Everyone? When the molecule doesn't contain a chiral carbon, but is chiral. Molecule is chiral. The carbon is not chiral. Everyone, please put your video on. Okay. Carbon, double bond, carbon, double bond, carbon. Iske upar do groups hai. Ek hydrogen hai. एक सीएल है, इसके ऊपर भी हाइड्रोजन एंड सीएल. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेल मी, इज देयर एनी sp3 हाइब्रिडाइज्ड कार्बन इन दिस? टेल मी द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ दिस कार्बन.
sp2.
sp2.
Hybridization of this carbon?
Sp2.
Very good. Hybridization of this carbon?
Sp2.
Is there any sp3 hybridized carbon? No. If there is no sp3 hybridized carbon, there is no chiral carbon. Can I say that? What do you feel? Is this particular molecule symmetrical or asymmetrical?
Symmetrical.
Can I say if the molecule is asymmetrical, it will be chiral? If the molecule is symmetrical, it will be achiral. Right? The way I represented the molecule here, you are feeling that it is symmetrical. Kyunki yahan pe break kar rahe aap log. Yahan pe Cl hai, yahan pe Cl hai, hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon, carbon. वैसे ही कुछ सोच रहे ना ओके बट दैट इज नॉट हाउ द मॉलिक्यूल इज दैट इज नॉट हाउ द मॉलिक्यूल इज One minute. Yeah. So यहाँ पे आपको ऐसा कुछ लग रहा होगा this molecule is symmetrical, but this is not symmetrical. Let us try to exactly represent the molecule with the help of these hybridizations. If this is sp2, suppose if I'm taking s, px and py. Okay. S, px and py. What is the orbit that is left for a pi bond? It is pz. Okay. Okay. If this is forming a pi bond with this carbon, this particular carbon should also have pz orbital. Agreed? What is the hybridization of this? What is the hybridization of this? It is sp na. Sp matlab ek s hoga. Pz to nahi hona chahiye because that pz is forming a pi bond with this pz. Agreed? So aur kuch batao kya ho sakta hai? It can have either py or pz, sorry, px, your wish. Okay, kya lo aap batao?
Yeah,
px, anything will be fine. I'm taking px. So it is left with which orbital?
Py.
Okay, this py, this carbon is forming a pi bond with this. So ye kiske sath banana chahiye? Py ke sath hi banayega pi bond. So the orbitals, ye sp2 hai. I'm sorry here. This is sp2. So the orbitals which are participating in hybridization are s, px and pz. Agreed? sp2 ka shape kya hai? What is the geometry or shape sp2 ka?
Trigonal
planar. So ye jo particular teen bonds hai, ye aur ye, these three will be in which particular plane?
XY
plane. ये जो तीन है, ये bond, ये bond, ये bond, ये किस plane में रहेंगे?
XZ
plane. XY plane और XZ plane जो रहेंगे, are they perpendicular to each other? XY and XZ planes are perpendicular to each other. Agreed? So if I represent the molecule, you should not show this like this. क्योंकि ये क्या है, दिस बॉन्ड्स आर इन द प्लेन बट द बॉन्ड्स आर नॉट इन द सेम प्लेन. दिस इज इन XY प्लेन, दिस इज इन XZ प्लेन. सो दिस इज नॉट द एक्चुअल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल. सो यू शुड नॉट से बाय लुकिंग एट दिस मॉलिक्यूल दिस इज सिमेट्रिकल. ओके, फर्स्ट हैव द एक्चुअल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ इट. हाउ विल इट लुक? C, double bond C, double bond C. Let us take this plane, the plane of paper, as XY plane. Okay. If the plane of paper is XY plane, यहाँ पे एक bond होगा, trigonal planar है ना, यहाँ पे एक bond होगा. On this you are having hydrogen and you have chlorine. Agreed? These two bonds will be in the plane perpendicular to it. Perpendicular मतलब extend होगा, मतलब क्या होगा, one of the bond will be going into the plane. One of the bond will be going perpendicular, okay, into the plane, and the other bond will be coming out of the plane. Any doubt, anyone? So, यहाँ पे आपको फिर से एक हाइड्रोजन है, यहाँ पे आपको you are having this chlorine. Agreed? Any doubt? If I am taking the mirror image of it, let's say mirror here, how will the mirror image look? Give me 2 minutes. यहाँ पे जो bonds है वो अभी यहाँ पे आ जाएगा. So you will be having hydrogen here, chlorine here. Now please analyze and tell me, are they superimposable or not? Hydrogen, chlorine. Are these two superimposable on each other? If I am trying to superimpose these two, superimpose hoga kya? These two are in plane. These two are out of the plane. Okay. This cannot be superimposed with this. You may feel वहां पे भी हाइड्रोजन है, यहाँ पे भी क्लोरीन है, but both of them are in different planes, ना? Agreed? आया समझ में? Clear है? If I am trying to rotate it by, suppose if you are feeling that I will be rotating it by 180 degrees, what will happen? ये हाइड्रोजन यहाँ पे आएगा, क्लोरीन यहाँ पे आएगा, सही है, but the hydrogen which is present into the plane, now it will be coming out of the plane. Chlorine which is present out of the plane, it will be going into the plane if I rotate by 180 degrees. So यहाँ पे क्या होगा, ये दोनों superimpose हो जाएगा इन दोनों के साथ, but here you will be having Cl and here you will be having hydrogen. Can they ever be superposed? No, right? So ये example, ये एक ही example आपको याद रखना है for JEE mains. Okay, NEET के लिए they may or may not ask, sometimes they may ask, for JEE mains this is important. Okay. This particular molecule, you may feel that this molecule is symmetrical, but it is not. This is a chiral molecule. Non-superimposable mirror images. Okay. Is this clear, everyone? Okay. Next. Once again, very important. RS configuration. If you have geometrical isomers, if you try to write the IUPAC name, or in general, if you have stereoisomers, if you write the IUPAC name, both the isomers will be having same IUPAC name. Agreed? So in order to differentiate yes. between geometrical isomers, हमने क्या किया? एक को cis रखा, दूसरे को trans रखा, और एक को e रखा, दूसरे को z रखा, और एक को sin रखा, दूसरे को anti रखा. Agreed? वैसा ही, if you want to differentiate between two optical isomers. Because both of them will be having same IUPAC name. If you want to differentiate between those two isomers, we will be assigning a configuration called RS configuration. Okay? Carbon CH3 Cl Hydrogen C2H5. Is this carbon chiral? It is attached to four different groups. It is chiral, and you have only one chiral carbon. So overall molecule will also be chiral. If I mark the mirror image of it, CH3, Cl, यहाँ पे hydrogen. C2H5. Agreed? Tell me the IUPAC name of these two. Normal IUPAC name.
Two chloro butane.
Butane hoga na? It is.
Two chloro butane.
Even this is 2-chlorobutane. So how to differentiate between these two? Both of them are two different compounds. So in order to differentiate between these two, we assign R and S configuration. Okay. In order to assign RS configuration, very important rule. First of all, you need to give priorities. Priorities scale the same rules. The one which is having higher atomic number will be having higher priority. Agar usse compare nahi kar pa rahe to, go for the forward. Go to the groups further. Okay, wherever there is a difference, that will be the more priority one. Okay. Lowest priority group. Lowest priority group. Should always be away from the observer, in order to assign RS configuration. If you want to assign RS configuration to any given molecule, the lowest priority group must always be away from the observer. मतलब क्या है? It should be present on this particular line. ये जो particular group है, this is away from us, right? This is coming towards us, and this is present in the plane. The lowest priority group must always be present here, then only you can assign RS configuration. अगर वहाँ पे नहीं है तो क्या करना चाहिए? We will understand with an example. सबसे पहले tell me the priority. Tell me the priorities. Chlorine has the highest atomic number, so इसके लिए one होगा. उसके बाद ये CH3 है या C2H5 है? Which will be having greater priority?
C2H5.
CH3 will be third priority. Lowest priority किधर है? It is away from us, right? Okay. The lowest priority group must always be away from us. Then only we will assign RS. So here it is away from us. You can assign RS. करना क्या है? You need to rotate. You need to see the path of 1, 2, and 3. यहाँ पे 1 है. This is 2. This is 3. Agreed? एक मिनट हाँ. Okay, what is the path you are following? 1 se leke 3 tak. You are following some clockwise path. 1, 2, 3. Forget about 4. It is viewed away from us. No need to take 4. Take the path of 1, 2 and 3. 1 ke baad 2 istead hai na? 2 istead hai kya? Beech mein 3 aa raha hai na? So 1, 2 and 3. The path is clockwise. If you are rotating it in the clockwise sense, clockwise path, it is called as R. Assign priority for this. This is 1. This is 2. This is 3. Lowest priority is away from us. Is case mein 1, 2 and 3. Kis side ja rahe?
Anti-clockwise.
Anti-clockwise. Okay. This will be called as S. Anti-clockwise, it is called as S. So this will be R2-chlorobutane. This is S2-chlorobutane. And this R and S has nothing to do with D and L. R can be D, R can be L. How to get if it is dextrorotatory or levorotatory? You need to put this particular compound in the polarimeter. If the compound rotates the plane polarized light in the clockwise sense, it will be called as D. Ajo clockwise, ajo anti-clockwise, it has to nothing to do with the plane of the polarized light. Okay. This is as per rules. So R आपको L भी हो सकता है, D भी हो सकता है. Similarly S आपको L भी हो सकता है, D भी हो सकता है. Is that clear? Okay, everyone. Okay, I'll give you some questions. Please assign R and S configuration. यहाँ पे और एक note जैसे लिखता हूँ. R can be dextro or levo similarly S can be If I say R is dextro, like then I can definitely say
S is levo.
S is levo. Okay. Very good. Question. Assign RS configuration. Everyone put their video on. Mark these questions. Assign RS configurations. Send all its configurations to these three. Everyone put your video on fast. Please tell me the answers. SN priority, if you are rotating it in clockwise sense, it is R. Anti-clockwise sense, S. Answer?
First one
is
R.
R.
This is one. RSR is the right answer. If you mark the answer for one, rest all other, you can directly mark without even seeing the priorities. Kaise batata hun, dekho. Fluorine highest atomic number, ye one hoga, ye two rahega, ye teen, 1, 2, 3 kaafi hai, fourth group, the lowest priority is away from us, so you can assign RS configuration. 1, 2, 3. Kaise gumaya? Clockwise. So this has to be R. Okay. Uske baad, observe these two. By interchanging two groups, fluorine is interchanged with C2H5 and C2H5 is interchanged with fluorine. Agreed? यहां से यहां पे आया बाय इंटरचेंजिंग टू ग्रुप्स व्हिच आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द सेम कार्बन यू विल गेट द आइसोमर ऑफ इट सो इफ दिस इज आर दिस शुड डेफिनेटली बी एस समझा एग्रीड By interchanging two groups which are present on the same carbon, you will be getting an isomer. Isomer मतलब उसका ये आ रहे तो दूसरा S होगा. और फिर से आप लोग देख सकते हो, this is one, this is two, this is three. The lowest priority is away from us. 1, 2, 3 rotated in anti-clockwise direction, so it is S. यहाँ पे फिर से this CH3 and fluorine are interchanged. ये और ये में फर्क क्या है? The CH3 and fluorine are interchanged. By interchanging two groups which are present on the same carbon, you will get isomer of it. So S का isomer क्या होगा? R होगा. Okay. यहाँ पे देखना. पहले ये mark कर लेते. This is one. This is two. This is three. This is four. 1, 2, and 3 rotating in clockwise direction, so it has to be R. Agreed? If you are doing one exchange, यहाँ पे देखो, you are doing only one exchange, so it is leading to its isomer, which is S. Is compound, what is the difference? You did two exchanges. इसको इसके साथ exchange किया, उसके बाद इसको इसके साथ exchange किया. I have exchanged these two first, then I have exchanged these two. So you are doing two exchanges. एक exchange करने से उसका isomer बनेगा, दूसरा exchange करने से फिर से क्या होगा? You will be forming the same compound. Understand this logic. Very important for problem solving in entrance exams. If you are exchanging two groups which are present on the same carbon once, you will be getting its isomer. If you are exchanging it again, you will be getting the same compound. Agreed? फिर से exchange करो. फिर से क्या आएगा? Isomer आएगा. फिर से exchange करो. Same compound. So if you do odd number of exchanges, what you will get?
Isomer.
If you do even number of exchanges, what will you get?
Same compound.
Agreed? So use this logic while solving questions. Okay. I'm writing a note here. And you can use the same logic in order to find the configuration. If the lowest priority is not viewed away from us, I will give you a question. Try to apply this particular rule and try to get the configuration. If we do odd number of exchanges, what will happen? Inversion of configuration. Inversion of configuration का मतलब क्या है? R तो S होगा, S तो R होगा. If we do even exchanges, you will have retention. What is meant by retention? जो पहले configuration रहा, वही configuration होगा. Retention of configuration. Next question. Try to solve this. Last two questions for the day. Solve these two. Ho jayega. Mark the configuration of this compound. Mark the configurations of these two compounds.
दोनों आ रहा है
क्या? नॉट द राइट आंसर.
फर्स्ट वन एस आर है.
इफ फर्स्ट वन इज एस, दैट्स द राइट आंसर. सेकंड वन भी एस है. दोनों आर नहीं है, दोनों एस है. आपको करना क्या है? सबसे पहले गिव द प्रायोरिटी. एवरीवन प्लीज टेल मी द priority.
Fluorine
is first priority. Yes, atomic number. उसके बाद OH होगा. Oxygen का atomic number ज़्यादा है. COH is greater than CHO.
Yes.
F3 है, F4 है. So the lowest priority is not queued away from us. So इस configuration में आपको RS, you should not assign it. Okay, you should not say 1, 2, 3 ऐसा घुमा रहा हूँ. ये करना ही नहीं है. RS configuration तभी assign करेंगे if you have the lowest priority away from you. So if it is not away from you, first bring that away from you. उसके लिए क्या करना क्या चाहिए आपको? Exchange these two. But if you are exchanging these two, what will you get? You will be getting the isomer of it. Agreed? By exchanging two groups. Which are present on the same carbon, you will be getting an isomer of it. So what you should do? Exchange these two as well. Do bar exchange kar liya na? If you are exchanging once, you will be getting isomer. Do two exchanges. Isko bhi karo, isko bhi kar lena. What will happen then?
Same compound.
You will get the same compound. Okay. So isko aap log make this as COOH. This will become fluorine. Now see the priority. This is 4. This is 2. This is 1. This is 3. Agreed?
Yes.
1, 2 and 3. Anti-clockwise hai na? So hua kya hai? This is S. Is that clear? Whenever the lowest priority is not away from you, bring that away from you by exchanging. But if you are exchanging, you will be getting isomer of it. अभी इसको और एक तरीके से भी आप लोग कर सकते हो. If you are doing only one exchange, everyone understand this. I am doing only one exchange. मतलब यहाँ पे OH आया, यहाँ पे आपको CHO है. Leave this as it is. You are having fluorine here and you are having COOH here. If you assign priority, this is 1, 2, 3, 4. If you are rotating this, you can assign RS configuration to this. Aapko R aa raha hai. Okay. But this is the configuration of the isomer because you have exchanged it. So, इसका जो भी कॉन्फ़िगरेशन आता है उसका उल्टा लिख लेना आंसर. ओके, दिस इज ये जो ऐसा आर आया है दिस इज कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ आइसोमर ऑफ गिवन कॉम्पाउंड. Either you can do two exchanges or you can do one exchange, write the configuration, uska answer ulta. Okay, so given compound ka configuration kya hoga? S hoga. Samjha? Understood? You can assign RS configuration if and only if the lowest priority is viewed away from you, but lowest priority yaha pe hai. It is in the plane. So in order to take that away from you, you need to exchange this. But if you are exchanging it, you will be getting the configuration of the isomer. So original configuration kya hoga? S hoga. Or else do two exchanges. By doing even number of exchanges, you are not changing the configuration. Isko bhi invert kar lo. So configuration of these two molecules are same. Viewed in different ways. A molecule dono same hi hai. ABSA, same here. Plane of paper, it is represented in a different way. Clear hai? Everyone. So tell me the answer for the second question.
Yes.
Priority. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should not assign configuration R and S for this. Only after exchanging you need to do that. So yahan pe 4 kahan pe hai? So yahan pe CSV aa jayega. Kya karna hai aapko? Do bar exchange karna hai ya ek hi bar exchange karna hai? Ek bar hi karke ulta likhna hai kya?
Yes.
ओके देन इसको C2H5 जैसा ही छोड़ो. दिस विल बी CH2OH. सो नाउ दिस इज 4, दिस इज 1, 2, 3. कैसे घुमा रहे आप लोग? 1, 2, 3 क्लॉकवाइज घुमा रहे ना. सो दिस इज आर. इफ दिस इज आर दिस विल बी
एस.
Yes. Agreed? Clear hai? Yes. Okay, I'll give you some homework. Please solve those questions. Homework hai? It is very tiring to have this representation, na? Ek po into the plane, ek po out of the plane. Agreed? So in the next lecture, we will be seeing another representation where we will represent the molecule like this. These are the 4 bonds. Okay? Because ye jo draw karna bahut mehnat lag raha hai na? Agreed? We will be simply drawing this plus sign. We will understand about this representation in tomorrow's lecture. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. This is your homework. We'll meet in tomorrow's lecture. Any doubts? Any doubts from today's lecture? Go through the notes. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in tomorrow's lecture. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye.